Welcome back. This is 10 News. Let's go back now to 10's political editor, Hugh Rimmington, who's in Canberra. Hugh, let's look at the opposition now. Tony Abbott, well, he didn't miss the opportunity to twist the knife today in Parliament. Of course, there was a very brief question time. He moved a motion of no confidence. Where to now, though, for Tony Abbott? We understand he's due to speak shortly.
Yes, he's going to be giving his reaction, and he will make his claim that nothing's been resolved, Labor's a shambles, etc., etc. But what was intriguing today is that he had to launch, and Julie Bishop, his deputy, had to launch, in a sense, a two-pronged attack. Much of it initially was directed at Julia Gillard as the Prime Minister, but they assumed, as others did, that Kevin Rudd, who was sitting there busily taking notes in his backbench seat, that he would be a candidate and that he might very likely win it. And so during the course of the attack on the government, they started to redirect their guns against, not specifically, there were a couple of things that the member for Griffith, Kevin Rudd, specifically that he wouldn't improve things in any way, but against the Labour Party in general. They plainly assumed that there was at least a pretty good chance that by the end of today, Kevin Rudd would be Prime Minister again, and they'd better aim a bit of fire in his direction, start taking a bit of paint off him. Now, as we know, Kevin Rudd is not Prime Minister, and the reason for that is that he flummoxed a lot of his own real supporters when he said he would not be challenging. Here's how he phrased it as he went into that caucus meeting.
I've been very plain about that for a long period of time. Secondly, I've also said that the only circumstances under which I would consider a return to the leadership would be if there was an overwhelming majority of the parliamentary party requesting such a return, drafting me to return, and the position was vacant. I'm here to inform you that those circumstances do not exist. And therefore, in the absence of any such draft, notwithstanding what Simon Crean had to say this morning, I will be adhering absolutely to the commitment that I gave to the Australian people and to my parliamentary colleagues. This is a difficult day for the Australian Labor Party, it's a difficult day for the Australian government, but I take my word seriously. I've given that word, I gave it solemnly in that room after the last ballot, and I will adhere to that word today.
Of course, Hugh, we still have, well, 6 months odd before this election. We heard from Julia Gillard there, the mantra was back to work. That is indeed what this government has to do now.
Well, that's right. What we heard there from Kevin Rudd was that he would not challenge. He would only be drafted if the position was vacant and he was satisfied there was an overwhelming majority who wanted him. Now, when you have a leadership spill, when the positions are spill, technically the position is vacant. So, in other words, it's not a challenge. You just put your name forward. So the key phrase there that you'd hear from Kevin Rudd is overwhelming majority. The signal I would read from that is that he was not certain he'd have the numbers. He certainly was certain that he didn't have an overwhelming majority. The position was technically vacant. It was there for him to have a crack at under the party rules. It looks to me as if in the final analysis he judged he did not have the numbers. Rather than go to a defeat or possibly a very narrow win, but one suspects a defeat, he pulled himself out of the game. So that is why the Prime Minister was able to go in there, be elected unopposed, Wayne Swan elected unopposed. Simon Crean said that he would stand for the deputy's position, but as his plan plainly collapsed around him when Kevin Rudd wouldn't stand, he did not stand against Wayne Swan, and so the two of them are there. So that means, as we've been saying, they do have this 7 weeks before the budget to get on with the very important business of putting a budget together in an election year. Once the budget is underway, we are then absolutely in the home run. There are two more sitting weeks in June and then on to September for the election. At the moment, the odds have steepled round in favour of Julia Gillard taking the Labor Party to that election in September, because Kevin Rudd, defeated last year, pulling out of any kind of a vote today, is plainly not a candidate. This has been an extraordinary day, and if there's been one big victim, a self-inflicted wound, it is Simon Crean. He brought on the leadership vote today, believing Simon Crean would not only run but have the numbers. He has lost his front bench position. Joel Fitzgibbon, the chief whip, who is a Rudd supporter, says he will consider his position. A few people wounded, but not the Prime Minister.
Thank you very much for the update there, Hugh Rimmington. Well, once again, if you are just joining us, here's what we know right now after this spectacular day in Canberra. A leadership ballot has been held this afternoon after the Prime Minister was pressured into calling the vote. Kevin Rudd did not contest the leadership, and Julia Gillard, well, she now remains Australia's Prime Minister. Let's take a look now at some of the extraordinary scenes today from Canberra.
Thank you very much. I intend to make a short statement.